As a result of architectural changes and memory DIMM errors, there is a difference in which errors will be corrected between the previous generation of processors and the Xeon Scalable processor family generation. This may result in rising DIMM errors being seen on your server. The components affected are Cisco UCS M5 platforms. The products affected are as listed here, and the release certification matrix, the RCMs affected, are listed as well. To verify what your current settings and your server types are, you can use the GUI or CLI. If using the UCSM Manager GUI, then point the browser at the IP address of your UCSM Manager and log in as user admin and customer supplied password. On the left-hand side of the UCS Manager, you can see your equipment. Under equipment, you can choose chassis. And from there, you will see all of the chassis is listed on the right-hand side with the servers on each chassis also listed. If you expand the name of the servers, then you can see each server is numbered per chassis. Double-click on the server and it will take you into a hardware view. And also from the menu, you can choose the installed firmware for that particular server. There you can see what the current BIOS setting is. And you can also see this is an M4 server with the package version on it. You can also get this through inventory and motherboard. Under inventory and motherboard, you can go into the BIOS settings and see what your current advanced memory settings are set to. Under advanced, you go to RAS memory, and under there you can see the memory RAS config is set to maximum performance, which was the default up until this new and improved firmware version for M5 servers. You can also get this information via CLI if you log in via PuTTY. And here you can also see the show server. If you double tag, then you can see all options available to you. And from here, the show server inventory, it will show us the same information for the service that we just saw through the GUI. Again, you can see these are M3 series and M4 series servers. And listed here also, the show server version will give you the firmware information as shown here. So that lists it per server, and it also gives you the BIOS information and the package version and the current status. It's pretty much the same information that we just saw through the GUI. If you like, you can drill down into each individual server as well. So scope server, the 1-1, which is the one we're looking at in the GUI. And from there, you can drill down into the BIOS and the BIOS settings. And in the BIOS settings, we can check the current setting, memory, RAS configuration settings as well. To update these, if you had an M5 server, to update it, you need to update the firmware. And the memory RAS setting default is a DDD CSS bearing for the new version of the firmware. As seen in the previous demo, earlier releases had memory configuration set to maximum performance. For Cisco M5 series servers, we recommend to upgrade to the UCS version to 4.13b or later. For this release and later, default memory configuration is set to adaptive double device data correction, which is a DDDC sparing. This tracks correctable memory errors and dynamically maps out failing regions by putting those banks and ranks into virtual lockstep mode. The RCM releases which support this are listed here.
Thank you for watching.